Hello students, welcome to EPG Patashala. I am Dr. U. Ratna, Assistant Professor, Department of Textiles and Clothing, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. The module we are going to see today is about weft knitting. Knitting is the method of manufacturing fabric by means of intermeshing of yarns by looping. Loops are formed by needle action while a loop is taken through one or more loops and the stitch is produced. Loops, or otherwise called as stitches, is possibly created in a horizontal direction or in vertical direction. Horizontal direction of loop formation is called the weft knitting and the vertical direction of loop formation is called as warp knitting. The both are the main classification of the knitting technology which is used in the industry. The objective of the module is to enable the students to understand different weft knitter structures, to elaborate on the different knitting needles used in the industry, and to understand the machines used in weft knitting. Coming to the weft knitting, a weft knitted fabric contains horizontal or parallel row of courses of yarn to be knitted. It requires just a single yarn to form a fabric, but more number of yarns is fed with respect to the machine capacity. Weft knitted fabric is used widely in the clothing industry, for example, hosiery, sweaters, foundation garments, and active wear. The most important benefit of weft knitted fabric is its construction techniques. The fabric is capable to stretch and recover, thus match to the body shape. To achieve a desired fabric performance properties, the selection of suitable fibers and yarns are taken into consideration. Coming to the classification of weft knitting, the following points are taken into consideration in the weft knitting classification based on the different approaches. That is, from the machine frame and needle bed arrangement, circular knitting and flat knitting to be considered. And in number of needle bed, single jersey and double jersey are done. And end product, fabric machine and garment machine. And in basic fabric structure, it is single jersey or plain, rib, interlock and purl. Coming to the type of needle used, by using latch needle, circular knitting and flat bed knitting is done. By using springbed needle, circular knitting and straight bar knitting is done. Coming to the knitting elements, a knitting machine is an equipment for converting yarn into a knitted loop structure by means of mechanical moving parts, either manual or power operated. These mechanical or electromechanical parts are called as knitting elements to convert yarn into knitted fabric. Circular knitting machine elements are possibly divided into primary knitting elements and secondary knitting elements. The primary knitting elements are actually forming the stitches by means of needles and sinkers. The secondary knitting elements are activating the needles and sinkers. Such knitting elements are cylinder, dial, cams, and pattern wheels. Except dial, remaining all the knitting elements are common to all kind of weft knitting machine, and dial is used only in double jersey knitting machine. Coming to the needles, needle is the primary element of the knitting machine and it is hooked metal piece. The knitting needle gets the yarn from the yarn feeder and converts it into a knitted loop. This loop is enclosed in the hook and finally drawn through the old loop. The needle has to rise from the normal position to clear already held loop and to collect the new loop from the feeder. The new feed yarn form a loop in the needle hook since the needle starts to slide down to retain the new loop and to knock off the old loop. For that reason, all needles should have various methods of closing and opening the needle hook to keep hold of the new loop and leave off the old loop. As a result, needles are classified into three types as shown in figure 2. The latch needle, the springbed needle and the compound needle. The needle parts can be divided into four main parts. First one is the hook. This receives and retains the thread to be looped. And the second one is the hook opening and closing device. It permits the hook to get a new yarn and release the old loop. Next is the butt. This is inserted with the cam system to lift and descend the needle for loop formation. Last is the stem, a system which allows the loop to slide on the surface and the needle move up and down. The spring bear needle. The needle is a shape of round wire system with a beard hook end. Opposite the point of the beard, there is a groove in the shank which permits the needle eye, forced by auxiliary mechanism, to close the needle hook. The spring bear needle needed an auxiliary mechanism, that is a presser, to seal the needle hook. The opposite end of the needle is equipped with but to raise and move down the needle for knitting action. The latch needle is called as a self-acting needle. This type of needle is shaped into a flattened wire shank with a latched hook end. The latch swings by the rivet and closes the tip of the hook, but it is placed in the opposite end of the needle and inserted with a cam to move up and down. There is no auxiliary device is required to form a loop. The last one is the compound needle. The compound needle has advantages of both the beard and latch needles. It consists of two individually controlled parts, that is the shank and tongue. Both parts of the compound needle require independent and precise control system. This system is not a key trouble in warp knitting because all the needles are activated together. However, in weft knitting, it may create problems at the time of loop formation. Coming to the sinker, it is a thin metal piece of material which is arranged between the needles, and it is a secondary primary knitting element. During the loop formation, sinker moving at right angles to the needles by a special sinker cam and executes one or more of the following operations. First one is help for the loop formation. Sinker is to go under the surface and bend the newly laid yarn into loop. And in holding down, the sinker hold down the old loops at a lower level on the needle stems. And in knocking over, sinker upper surface or belly supports the old loop as the new loop is drawn throughout it. Coming to the cams, it is a device which can convert the rotary force into a suitable reciprocating movement is called as cam. The reciprocating action of knitting needles and sinkers are independently controlled by knitting cams. Conventional knitting machine cams are mostly single track cam to produce only the basic knitted structures. Further, increasing the complexity of the knitted structure, multiple cam tracks are needed for each set of needle movement. The cam are employed either independently or in a unit form of cam system, and it depends upon the design of machine. Separate cam system are necessary for each feeder to receive the yarn by the needle. In a cam system, various sections are available to control the needle movement, and it is shown in figure 1. That is the guard cam, which define a boundary to the movement of buds and to prevent the knitting needle falling out from the track. Second is a raising or clearing cam. It lifts the needle in different heights according to the fabric structure requirement. Next is the stitch cam to control the yarn length to form needle loop by controlling the descending movement of the needle. At the same time, it functions as a knockover cam. Upthrow cam to obtain the needles to return back to the relaxed position. And the running cam, the needles from the relaxed place to a knitting cycle to create new loops. Coming to the cylinder, it is a metal plate which acts as a needle bed to support and hold the needle in the knitting action. Outside wall of the cylinder made up of tricks are called cuts. And the figure 5 shows the needles that are placed to each trick, and the arrangement of needles are depend upon the design features of knitted structure. The bud protrudes from the needle and the needles are arranged perfectly vertical. This protruded bud travels along the cam track, which provides the preferred movement to the needle. Next is the dial. It is a metal plate placed perpendicular to cylinder, which acts as a needle bed to support and hold the horizontal needles in the knitting action. Like cylinder, outside wall of the dial made up of tricks are cuts. Dial is the main knitting element in double jersey knitting machine. Coming to the circular weft knitting machine, it is a predominant knitting machine producing varieties of knitted fabrics according to the applications. It produces tubular knitted fabric with the help of mechanical or electromechanical components. It can be classified into two types based on the number of needle bed. First one is single jersey knitting machine, which uses one set of vertical needle, produces plain knitted fabric and its derivatives. The second one is double jersey knitting machine, which uses two sets of needles to produce a ribbon interlock fabrics. And the single jersey knitting machine is a circular knitting machine in which needles are placed in a vertical groove on the surface of the cylinder. The cylinder needle butts are protruding in the cam track, which is provided reciprocating movement to the needles. The machine function can be divided into different zones, that is a creel zone, knitting zone and takedown zone. The creel zone consists of creels, thread guide, tensioner, stop motion, feeders and yarn monitoring devices. The knitting zone consists of primary and secondary knitting elements. The takedown zone has a spreader and take-up mechanism. The supply package cone is converted into knitted fabric and produced into tube form. Three stronger cast iron legs are provided to hold the parts and components of the knitting machine and its anchor on the floor. A heavy-duty motor is used to drive the cylinder and necessary parts of the knitting machine. And the passage of yarn, the supply package is coned, placed on the creel and the yarn is unwound and passed through the thread guides and top stop motion. Different stages of stop motions are used to stop the machines immediately to avoid major defect. Subsequent to that, the yarn passes through the middle stop motion and tensioners. The positive yarn feeding system is placed in between the stop motion to feed the yarn positively. This positive feeder may be a storage feeder that unwound the supply of yarn from creel continuously and carry the thread in uniform tension. From the positive feeder, the yarn feed to the knitting zone in a constant rate and the feed yarn tension is maintained. The knitting elements in a knitting zone begin to knit a fabric. The knitting needle raise and descend to form a loop and this process is supported by the remaining knitting elements. After that, knitted fabric is taken down in inside of the cylinder through take-up mechanism and finally wound on the fabric roller without loop distortion and creases. Before wound the tubular fabric on the cloth roller, the spreader is used to maintain the diameter of the knitted fabric and spreader positioned inside the tube of the knitted fabric. The cloth roller is collected at the bottom of the circular weft knitting machine. Coming to the double jersey knitting machine, the basic principles of the loop formation in double knitting jersey machine is that it has the same single jersey knitting machine. Here the machine equipped with two set of needle, one is cylinder needle and one is the dial needle. Both are combined to form a knitted loop structure. The arrangement of needle in cylinder and the dial in a machine decide the type of fabric to be produced. Rib and interlock can be manufactured through double jersey knitting machine. Rib knitted fabric has a vertical cord-like appearance for the reason that loops in veil direction form the face loop and reverse alternatively or vice versa. In rib knitted fabric manufacturing, two sets of needles are alternatively used and it is arranged in a set of gated between each other. In a rib gating, the needles are arranged in the cylinder and between the needles of the dial, it is shown in figure 7. The knitting action of the clearing, that is the cylinder needles and dial needles move to clear the old loops formed in the earlier cycle. And in yarn feeding, the needles are reserved and the open latches cover the old loops and new yarn is supplied into the needle hook portion. And in knocking over, the needles are reserved in action, the old loops are knocking over and the fresh loops are hanged through them. Coming to the interlock knitting machine, interlock knitted fabrics is produced mostly on a particular type of cylinder and dial circular machines with two different heights of needles. To produce interlock fabric, the entire course involves two feeder course system. While considering the feeders individually, every feed yarn knits on alternate needles to its corresponding cylinder and dial to manufacturing two 1:1 rib structures. At first, the interlock machine has two needle height, that is long and short needle for both cylinder and dial. The arrangement of interlock needle gating is long needle in cylinder exactly facing at right angles to short needle in dial and vice versa. To construct this knitted structure, two individual cam tracks used to controlling the long and short needles in the cylinder and same type of setup is applicable for dial. In figure 8 shows the odd yarn knit with long needles of cylinder and dial produces the first alternate whales, and event feeders yarn knit with short needles of cylinder and dial produces second alternative whales. While considering this structure individually, it is 1-into-1 drip structures, but in combined together, the operation of all the feeders and needles in interlock machine produces interlock structure. Here, the appearance of the fabric on both face and back are reflecting the same structure. Coming to the basic weft net structures, weft knitted structure is manufactured either by means of a circular or flat knitting machine. In both knitting system, knitted fabrics are produced by looping the feed yarn in horizontal or coastwise direction to the width of cloth. Here, the horizontal loops, that is the courses, vertical loops, which is the faces, the loop and back loop are called the major deciding factor for the basic weft knitted structures. The following four weft knitted structures are taken as primary or basic parental structures. That is the plain structure, which is called a single jersey, rib structure, interlock structure, and the pearl structure. First is the plain structure. It is known as single knit structure or single jersey. It is produced by means of a single set of needles, and two types of structures can be possible, that is the technical face and technical back. In technical face, the loops are formed by drawing the new loops through the old loop at front, and of the new loop is covered the head of the old loop, showing the appearance of V columns in the whale direction. Coming to the technical back, the new loops are formed under the old loop and the foot of the new loop is covered by the head of the old loop, showing the appearance of inverted U's, rows in the coast direction. Plain structure weft knitted fabric produced with face loop stitches on the fabric face side and back loop stitches on the fabric back side. Coming to the rib structure is one of the double jersey knitted fabrics manufactured with alternate face and whales or vice versa by means of cylinder and dial. In figure 10 shows the fabric produced with the face loop and back loop alternatively in whale direction, showing the vertical stripped appearance on either side of fabric. Because of the same appearance on the face and back of the fabric, it is a reversible knitted structure. 1-into-1, 2-into-2, 3-into-3 are called the balanced rib knitted structures. Unbalanced rib structure can be produced with small modification in knitting needle lifting action. Coming to the interlock structure, it can be produced by a special arrangement in the weft knitting needle and knitting action. It was initially derived from the rib knitted structure. In figure 11, A represents first 1-into-1 B structure and B shows the second 1-into-1 rib structure. With the meshing of two 1-into-1 rib knitted structure produces a regular interlock structure. By hiding the look of the reverse loop through knitting process, each side of the fabric shows only face loop. Coming to the pearl structure, it is a special kind of structure producing special knitting machine. Two cylinder knitting machine is used with the two hook end needles. The latch needle is the most convenient double-ended needle for the manufacturing of pearl structure. Loops are formed by alternate face course and the back course or vice versa by means of two cylinders. Coming to the characteristics of basic weft knitted structures, first one is the appearance, whereas in single jersey it is the face and back differs. In 1-into-1 rib, face and back are identical. In interlock, face and back are identical, and 1-into-1 pearl, face and back are identical. And coming to the extensibility, twice extension on widthwise than the length direction, and twice extension on widthwise than the single jersey, and the length is same as single, and twice extension on widthwise than the single jersey, more rigid than the single jersey, and twice extension on the lengthwise than the length direction. Coming to the curl or roll, in the first one, the fabric edge will tend to curl or roll, and the second it does not curl, and the third also does not curl, and the last structure also does not curl. And coming to the unravel, from either end, unraveled course by course in the single jersey, only from the last course, unravel course in the rib, and 2 feet yarn must be unraveled to complete the knitted course in the third structure, and from either end, unraveled course by course in the last structure. Coming to the fabric thickness, twice of feed yarn diameter, twice of single jersey fabric, it is the third one, twice of the single jersey fabric, and in the last structure, it is also the twice of the single jersey fabric. So to conclude, I would like to say that wet knitted fabrics are widely used in clothing industry, that is the knitting industry, and the knitting elements play an important role in the functioning of the knitting machines. And coming to the wet knitted structure, it is manufactured by means of a circular or by flat knitting machine, and the wet knitting machines are the most commonly used machine in the knitting industry. And the basic wet knitted structures are single jersey, rib jersey, interlock and purl. And the commonly used structure of the wet knitted fabric is the single jersey fabric. So hope you have understood about the needles, machines, structures of wet knitting clearly. Thank you.